welcome to the 1st of December, the first day of Advent, if you know, don't count from Sunday. I mean, you can count Advent from Sunday, which was the first Sunday of Advent. But today is December 1st and the start of the Advent calendars. Do you have a calendar? I know that many of my friends, knitting friends here in Norway, they have a kind of yarn calendar with 24 small parcels, which they can open one every day to get yarn or knitting related stuff. I don't have that. Last year, I had a wonderful calendar given to me by one of my knitting friends, and it was amazing. It was 24 gifts, of course, obviously, one for each day, and it was such a joy every morning to wake up and to open one of these gifts. What I do have, which I've had for many, many years, it's, well, it's also a kind of Advent calendar. It's an Advent basket. Every night during Advent, or I started last night, every night I fill the basket with different things which I use to prepare for Christmas. I'm used to the tradition of starting decorating for Christmas only on the 23rd of December, Little Christmas Eve, as we call it here in Norway, Lille Julaften. I realized when, because I'm a collector, I have so many different collections. Among them is a collection of nativities, mangers, and I wanted to put them up, start to put them up, decorate with them during Advent. So I made this basket. It's an idea given to me by a dear friend many years ago. And every morning then the basket is waiting for me on the mantelpiece near the fireplace. And I open it. It's an angel in here. It's a book. It's a sheet of Christmas music. And there are some other secrets, surprises down here. I will show you more of it as the days of Advent unfolds. So that's my Advent calendar. We have also very slowly started to decorate the house. The main manger is up. Manger, you say? Manger? Manger? Nativity? And I started to clean the living room yesterday. And I will clean the kitchen and the other rooms as well, of course, as the day comes. And the first nativity of the small nativities is up. I have collected nativities since 1998. And I have a couple of hundred or more. And of course I can't decorate with them all. They are in two big glass cupboards down in a basement room. But every day I bring out one and place it somewhere. You saw a couple, three I think, in the first video here, and you will see a lot more during this period of Advent and also Christmas. This year I even started a special blog to show one nativity every day. Because I have collected them for such a long time, it's easy to forget where I bought them, the tales behind them and everything I know about when I bought them and so on. So now I have started to collect all that in a blog. The blog is in Norwegian, but you can of course always see the pictures and you find it and everything connected with my blogging and waiting for Christmas and Advent and so on my webpage, brittarnhild.no. I will put a link down here. Do you know the story of the Advent calendar? I didn't until a few years ago when I found this book. It's an English book, Waiting for Christmas, written by Kathleen Long Bostrom, illustrated by Alexei Natchev. I bought it on Amazon, I think. It's in a series called Traditions of Faith from around the world, waiting for Christmas. And it tells the story of a little boy, Gerard, because he was German, they say Gerard. And we also say Gerard in Norway. It tells the story about his mother helping him to make the waiting time easier. So you see, she has made a tray for him with 24 squares with one little cookie in every square. So we can, we are told the story here in this book with Gerard finding the days very, very long. He's helping his father, decorating the father's church and so on. But and then his mother makes this tray of cookies for him. It's a beautiful story. If you don't have the book, I will recommend you to look for it on Amazon. And in the back of the book is even an advent calendar. It's this sheet of paper with a Christmas tree and 24 circles. And circles are to put stickers on. And the stickers are, of course, made like Christmas cookies. By the way, I know that many of you like the Narnia reading from Sunday, on the first Sunday of Advent. And I must confess, I have continued to read by myself. I've almost finished this book about the lion, the witch, and the wardrobe now. And it's such a wonderful story. I have my Lectio Divina every morning, and reading that book has been a great joy the past couple of days. I will talk a lot more about books as the days unfold in this season of Advent. I will also talk a lot. Well, I will show you. 2 years ago, I knitted 24 miniature mittens with one number on numbers from 1 to 24. So that's also some kind of advent calendar, of course, because now I hang one mitten every day on a string which we have put on the piano. So on Christmas Eve, there will be 24 mittens hanging there. I will show you the mittens, of course, as the days come. And there will be a lot of knitting in these episodes. Yes, I will talk about this sweater. I know several of you have asked about that, but not today. In these small boxes, I have projects. I don't have 24 boxes, and I don't have 24 knitting projects either. But from time to time, I will open one of the boxes and show you what's inside. Last night, I started on a special project. It's here. I didn't knit much, but it will be an angel, a knitted angel. And it's a very special angel. And I will talk more about this angel and its story in a later episode. So I think this is what I have to share with you today, together with my mother's music, my 90 years old mother playing her piano, and some footage from the garden, from the house, and I'll see what I find. Thanks to all of you who follows me on this Advent series here on YouTube. I look forward to meet you again tomorrow. Bye.